Welcome to the first cooking programme of 2017. Anybody who watches my YouTube channel will know I've had a bit of paperwork done on my leg, so I'm banished from the workshop. That doesn't mean I can't clean the kitchen. What I'm going to do is make a meatloaf, a pork meatloaf. First thing I need, I've got some minced pork here, nice lean minced pork. Put that into a mixing bowl. Into that, I'm going to put various herbs, an onion, some apple, and some sage and onion mix. First thing I want to do is grate some onion. I've got a new knife here. It was kindly sent in by all my viewers, a lad called Rupert Powell. He's obviously sick of seeing us using blunt knives, and he sent this in, which is really sharp. You see, you've got less chance of cutting your fingers with a sharp knife than you have with a blunt knife. If you do cut your fingers, you make a proper job of it. As you can see, I've been off work for a few days now, so my hands have became nice and clean. I forgot to put the mask on, this is really starting to make my eyes stream. Oh, that looks better. It's having a better effect. Very coarsely grated. Yes, the eyes are really streaming now. Need roughly half an onion. I'm just about got half an onion in there now. Right, that's enough of that. Oh, dear God. Right, next thing is, I'm going to peel and grate some apple into it. This grates a lot easier than the onion, obviously. I also need to add a small quantity of apple juice. And some sage and onion stuff and mix. Just all blend it together. I think I'll try and use my Christmas cake blender for this. It did work well on the Christmas cake. Thank you. maybe just as well to go in with the hands actually. As I say, I've been off work so my hands are nice and clean now, which is a novelty for me. This pork mince was very lean, so what I made do was cut some streaky bacon up and put some streaky bacon in with the mix as well. That's starting to blend together quite nicely now. Really is nice having a sharp knife, makes a massive difference. Right, that's quite nicely mixed up now. A small quantity of mixed herbs. Black pepper. One final mix. Right, and that's basically ready to go. So it's a nice coarse mixture, that's exactly what I wanted. This is the tin I'm going to use for the meatloaf. It's a non-stick tin, but I've been told to line it with this paper just to make sure I don't things don't stick to it.
Grandma. Cut straight or an angle, right? Cut to this. Make it go like that. Turn it round. Same on the other side.
You've got like wallpaper.
A bit like wallpaper. Pick it up. Pull it in. And tuck it round.
I was going to do it that way.
Well, just in case you wanted to anyway, there you go. That's it roughly for you.
Right.
Okay, you can
take
it up.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Clever shite. Right. Right, we'll just leave it like that for the minute. What I'm also going to do is I'm going to line this with some streaky bacon. This also gets folded over the top as it's cooking, or when it's cooking rather. Once again, it's hardly what you'd call diet food, but I don't think once in a while it'll do you any harm. Right, so into there goes my meatloaf mix. Put it there on the bottom. Like that. I'm also going to in here put some hard boiled eggs. So when you cut into the meatloaf, you'll be cutting into the hard boiled eggs as well. Right, so I'm going to put in four hard boiled eggs and finish it off with the meatloaf mixture. That. And the bacon is simply folded over the top. This is then cooked in a medium oven for roughly an hour and a half. Right, so this now goes into a preheat oven, 160 degrees, it'll take roughly an hour and a half to cook. While that's cooking, I have got a little bit of meatloaf mixture left. I think I'll just fry it off and make a nice little burger. Absolutely splendid. Once again, it just remains to say thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing, and bon appetit, Bonnie La. Very nice.